Researchers at the University of Illinois at Chicago have engineered a potentially game-changing solar cell that cheaply and efficiently converts atmospheric carbon dioxide directly into usable hydrocarbon fuel, using only sunlight for energy. Unlike conventional solar cells, which convert sunlight into electricity that must be stored in heavy batteries, the new device essentially does the work of plants, converting atmospheric carbon dioxide into fuel, solving two crucial problems at once. A solar form of such artificial leaves could remove significant amounts of carbon from atmosphere and produce energy-dense fuel efficiently. The new solar cell is not photovoltaic, it is photosynthetic, the researcher says. Instead of producing energy in an unsustainable one-way route from fossil fuels to greenhouse gas, we can now reverse the process and recycle atmospheric carbon into fuel using sunlight. While plants produce fuel in the form of sugar, the artificial leaf delivers syngas or synthetic gas, a mixture of hydrogen gas and carbon monoxide. Syngas can be burned directly or converted into diesel or other hydrocarbon fuels. The ability to turn CO2 into fuel at a cost comparable to a gallon of gasoline would render fossil fuels obsolete. Chemical reactions that convert CO2 into burnable forms of carbon are called reduction reactions, the opposite of oxidation or combustion. Engineers have been exploring different catalysts to drive CO2 reduction, but so far such reactions have been inefficient and rely on expensive precious metals such as silver. The researchers focused on a family of nanostructured compounds called transition metal dihydryl cogenates, or TMDCs, as catalysts. Pairing them with an unconventional ionic liquid as the electrolyte inside a two-compartment, three-electrode electrochemical cell. The best of several catalysts they studied turned out to be nanoflake tungsten diselenide. The new catalyst is more active, more able to break carbon dioxide's chemical bonds. In fact, the new catalyst is 1,000 times faster than noble metal catalyst and about 20 times cheaper. Other researchers have used TMDC catalysts to produce hydrogen by other means, but not by reduction of CO2. The catalyst couldn't survive the reaction. The breakthrough was to use an ionic fluid called ethyl-methyl-imidazolium tetrafluoroborate mixed 50-50 with water. The combination of water and the ionic liquid makes a co-catalyst that preserves the catalyst's active sites under the harsh reduction reaction conditions. The UIC artificial leaf consists of two silicon triple junction photovoltaic cells of 18 square centimeters to harvest light. The tungsten diselenide and ionic liquid co-catalyst system on the cathode side, and cobalt oxide in potassium phosphate electrolyte on the anode side. When light of 100 watts per square meter, about the average intensity reaching the Earth's surface, energizes the cell, hydrogen and carbon monoxide gas bubble up from the cathode, while free oxygen and hydrogen ions are produced at the anode. The hydrogen ions diffuse through a membrane to the cathode side to participate in the carbon dioxide reduction reaction. The technology should be adaptable not only to large-scale use like solar farms, but also to small-scale applications. In the future, it may prove useful on Mars, whose atmosphere is mostly carbon dioxide, if the planet is also found to have water.